out, feel the world, rub the shoulder with the best, and enhance your potential. So what you want is, so normally when you submit a proposal, normally they'll be cross-checking your CV, cross-checking with other entities, other professional sites, etc. Normally, if you give a call to me, I will be asking, so what is your name? Where are you working? You know, what is the next step I'll be doing? I'll be typing your name. I have typed to Suresh Kuribilla, one of my friend, and I typed the name and I searched it. Oh, so you are the person. Boy, that's great. So this is the trend what we feel we see today. So what we'll be doing then, do you know, normally you'll be interested in being with the best. So normally you get associated with professional sites. The one of the popular one is LinkedIn. Please don't limit your activities in Facebook. Come to these kind of sites where you can interact with the best and you can be getting into some association. And normally, friends, you will be once in a while, you will be surprised to get a call seeking information whether are you interested in associating with a particular project. And slowly you will be getting dollars as well based on the number of man hours, not day, man hours. Per hour, they will be giving you money. So what do you need? Provide your services and get into these kind of sites. And then now the era is into e-learning and COVID is one of the important stakeholder, not the students. And it is that one that influencing our activities. So at the end of the day, what I want you to do is, now you have started, put your right foot strong and friend, and do something on e-learning, because e-learning research projects are coming shortly into dominance. So be there, work on it, and come up with some various add-ons that can enhance this process. So these are the things why e-learning is getting important. So for that, what you need to do is, you need to be in an e-learning module way back. So they will be searching the site to see whether you are into e-learning or something like that. So already we had created the e-learning module. Now take the tab, friends. Can you take a tab, log into your account and wait for my instruction? What I want is, I want this e-learning module which you have created to be visible in the virtual world, that is in Google search engine. Then by 12:30 you will be trying to search, but sometimes you will not be finding it because it takes a number of time and it lag to get live. So relax, don't worry. Slowly you can see when you search your name with that extension, it will be showing that your site is visible even in the search engine. Sorry, there is some audio problem because some construction is going on behind. I think I am audible to you. So that is beyond my capacity to restrict them to stop working. So this is it. Take a new tab. Go to your site, yourname.moodlecloud.com, log in and wait for me. Hello. Now, after that, what you need to do is, on the left-hand side, you can see site administration. Before that, remember the first important step, turn editing on. That is what I want first. After logging in, turn editing on, then only listen to me. These are your first duty. This should be your first priority. As and when you log in, you are an administrator, you will be shuffling things here and there. So do one thing, after logging in, turn editing on and wait for my instruction. Hope that I am not that fast. And on the left side, you can see a bar. And on the last part, you can see site administration. Click on to site administration. You can see the second item, that is, first item is notification. Second one is registration. Click on to registration. Click on to registration. Then it will be showing update your site registration. This is the site registration process which I had undertaken for my site. Don't search for this site because today only I have created. Because yesterday ma'am told that I should do it and show it to them. So normally see you should keep in mind that after 3 or 4 months when you log in, the site will be entirely different. So don't get disturbed by that, because as I told you, when you host in Moodle cloud, they will be updating every now and then. The whole system will be changing. So in as you have put your foot in e-learning, you should update every day. Okay, then now you can see the name, site listing. That is the important part. You can see, don't list my site. No, that is not what I want. Do not list my site. Only display my site name. And the last one is what I want. Show it to others. Display it in full format. Don't list my site. Only display my site name. There is no use of just displaying your site name. Somebody will be interested in this thing. So your site and the link all should be visible. Click on to the last one and go to the complete the process. Of course, you remember those red dots. The red dots conveys important thing. You should specify your country, your email address, and that I agree to follow the privacy notification and data processing agreement, because you are hosting it in Moodle's cloud. No, the data belongs to them as well, so you are accepting their terms and conditions. Then finally, you can see save changes, save, etc. Click onto that blue icon and go to the next one. So I am stopping this and I am waiting for you. Hello.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Hello.
Yeah, I am here.
Sir, display contact from me, kya likhenge? No, I don't not want to contact it by the other people or yes, provide the form.
It is up to you. Yeah, it is up to you. If you want the privacy element, it is up to you. You can give it. See, there is no hard and fast rule. If you don't want this, do this process, complete the registration without displaying it. It is up to you.
So with regard to the description, what we should write?
And the next
description, you can write what is the site meant for. This is the e-learning developed by Professor so and so for enhancing the teaching learning process. One second, please let me answer to the person and I will get back to you. This is what is the objective of this thing, and it will give some insight to the psychology of education, things like that. If you are a psychology faculty, and like that, you can explain, because they should sometimes the link along with these lines will be shown, so they will get to know what this site is. Normally, you know what I am suggesting is slowly you change your site into a paid one. Let others also come in and say visit your site, and you will be sometimes, if you are lucky, you will be getting not only rupees, dollars as well.
Thank you.
Okay, that's it. See, you have spent this much of money now. Try to earn from your site also, so that you can enhance the size of your pocket. Next one, please. Any questions? What I prefer is, see, I am interested in seeing my link in Google n number of times.
Sir, after update registration, what will do, sir?
Update. Just wait for me. I'll be coming back. First, let me complete the process of registration, because tomorrow or day after tomorrow, we'll be getting into some technicalities which will take you to trouble. That is why, because we'll be accessing it from some other thing. For that, you need to complete the registration process. That is why I am just waiting for them to complete the process. Yeah, update your site registration. Great, great. Come on, Kamala ma'am, go down the screen. If you have registered, you don't need to update, because it will be showing updated recently or something. Last updated 21 May. It is shown like that. Go to the top of the screen. You can see the blue band. On to the top. See. Wait. See the first line. Your site is registered. So you had completed the process. Friends, take a look at this one. Take a look at this page. You can see your site is registered. Registration last updated 21 May 2020. That means it is up to date. Hope everyone got this blue band with this information. Your site is registered. Registration last updated 21 May 2020. Okay, ma'am, Kamala ma'am, please stop. let me discuss with others as well. Yeah, next one please. Who is the next? I can see a P letter. Anyone? See, please share your screen.
I am not P, I am Argis. Sir.
Sir, but the alphabet shown is P, so maybe someone else. Sibichan, yes, sir, you are live. Sibichan, yes, sir, yeah. Your site is registered, registration last updated, 21 May. Stop. Tanya, ma'am, please be live. Yeah, you got the blue band, registration updated. Okay, stop. Can, next one, anyone issue? Vagi, sir, is there any issue?
Have you got this one, blue one? Only one doubt, sir. In the registration information, the name is, it is either our my site name or my personal name.
No, it will be taking the site name.
Oh, that is all.
Yeah, not your personal. If you want your personal name to be visible, change the name of the site also. Put as Vargis.
Okay,
so it will be showing as Vargis.
Okay,
that's it. So anyone else? So friends, can I go back? Okay then.
Shyamala sir.
Yeah, please tell me. I'm here.
Sir, എനിക്ക് തുടക്കം തൊട്ടേ ഒന്ന് കിട്ടിയില്ലായിരുന്നു അത് എന്താ ചെയ്യേണ്ടത്?
ലോഗിൻ ചെയ്തോ? First login. Vasu ma'am, just wait. Your registration is updated. Bohit, is it you? Bohit Johnson?
Yes.
Bohit, do one thing. First login.
Okay.
First login. Then do you know what is the first step, first thing you should do after logging in? Turn editing on.
Man, okay,
you should answer to me.
Okay, sorry sir. Yeah. Sorry sir.
Then go to the left side, you can see site administration.
Sir, it's not connecting. Sir, ഞാൻ ഓപ്പൺ ആക്കിട്ടേ. എനിക്ക് സാധാരണ ഇത് പോർട്ടൽ അക്കൗണ്ട് ലോഗ് ഔട്ട് എന്നൊക്കെ പറഞ്ഞൊരു ഇതാണ് കാണിക്കുന്നത്. കഴിഞ്ഞ ദിവസം കാണിച്ച പോലെ അല്ല കാണിക്കുന്നേ.
ഒന്നുമില്ല ധൈര്യത്തില്. What is the name of your site? Give me the name of your site. Let me check.
Bohit.
BOHITH. HITH.moodlecloud.com.
Yes.
.com. Okay.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
That's
open,
it.
Open.
Okay, then.
Okay. Then?
Then you need to turn editing on.
Okay.
Then after turn editing on, go to the right side. You can see site administration. So this button, you should be familiar. Friends, all of you should be familiar with this button, that is site administration. Because you are an administrator and you will be clicking on to it every now and then as you log into the site. So click on site administration. You can see the second item below that.
Site administration. Oh, okay.
Click onto that. You can see registration down below. Are you able to see that?
One minute, sir.
Neelu, ma'am, morning. Yes, ma'am. Your site is updated. Neelu, ma'am, you have done the process yesterday itself. How can you do that without my instruction? Neelu, ma'am, you registered itself yesterday itself. Or maybe your computer CMOS battery is not working.
Your site, yes sir, your site is registered. Registration last updated 19th May.
Okay, that's great.
Okay.
Vasu ma'am, you are live. Yes, it is updated. So friends, stop. Let me go to the next part. Vasu ma'am, can you stop? So that I can take up. Hello. Yes, please. So I'm back. Atithi ma'am. Now you can see the page as this one. When you go back, Can you do one thing, friends? Click on to home and go to your site. Click on to home, go to your site. You can see two courses there. One, the course which you had created. Another one, introduction to Moodle. If you want to have a polished look, let me tell you one thing. Remove that introduction to Moodle. You don't want that. You just want your content. Because now, with 3 days of experience, I think you got sufficient expertise in using logging into Moodle and things like that. So do one thing, manage course, delete introduction to Moodle. Delete only introduction to Moodle, not all the content created so far. What I want to see is, I have highlighted my course, behavioral economics. So I have just highlighted that one, that is in blue. And I want to see that only, the course which you had created rather than the demo thing which was created by them. Now the site belongs to me and I like to have only my content rather than anyone else's content. Even I am not even interested to host the thing provided by the service provider. So if you want, you can delete. If you are interested to hosting it on the site, it is up to you. So this is it. This is the first page of my site. Can I go on? You can do it after some time. Let me go to the important aspects of this program. Okay then. Now, when you take a look at this page, you can see this page different from yours. Do you know why? It is because the theme background which I use. What is the best color?
Share your screen.
Yeah, it is sharing. It is sharing. It is not coming, huh?
Not coming.
No, then I'll do it again. Hello? Is it visible, friends? Is it visible?
No, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes. Sir, pin them. Tell them to pin them up.
Yeah, that is. No, normally it will come up visible. Or else, pin it.
Sir, you have registered twice. And in the layout, we are able to see your presentation.
Yeah. Okay, okay. So, what I want? You want to me to start again? Okay then, do one thing. I am stop sharing. Okay, coming back to the thing. Is it visible now? Is it visible now? Hello?
Sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, great. Thank you. Thank you.
Yes,
so,
sir.
Coming
yes,
back.
Sir.
When you take a look at your page, you can see it is dull, dark, or boring. That is the words of me. It is not of yours. So take it in a lighter sense. So what I prefer is I like to have a professional look. Professional look, as you saw, see, which is the best dress to wear for an interview, my suggestion will be plain white. So I like to have a white background in my site just to show that it is a professional one. So what I did was, I came to site administration. Friends, go to site administration. Go down. Site administration, you can see registration. After that registration, Moodle services, advanced users, go down, down, down. You can see appearances. Click on to appearance. Click on to appearance. Friends, hope you have reached to that site. Mouse is nearby you and you should be, your fingers should be nimble and fast. Don't complain to the organizers that I am very fast. So in the computer era, in the virtual world, you should be fast. Not lagging and lethargic. So come to the appearance. Click on to appearance, you can see themes. Come to appearance, click on to appearance, you can see themes. Then theme settings, theme selector. Theme settings means if you are interested in giving some colorful outlook, you can change the color. Then click on to theme selector. Click on to theme selector, you can see underneath that Boost, Classic, Moodle Cloud, etc. You can give some other thing and see. This is the thing you can see after selecting the theme selector. You can see the Boost one, The other one is Classic. So that means I am using Classic, and if I want to change to Boost, I can change to Boost. Click onto that, save changes, and come back. Hope you have done it. Go to site administration. You can see notification, registration, etc., etc. Down below, you can see appearance. Click onto appearance. You can see theme modification, theme selector, etc. Click onto theme selector, and you can change the color, change the background, change the theme of the page. If you want to make some mix and match, as somebody is interested in fashion trends, means you can go to the link just above that. You can give the particular color of your preference. Hope you understood that. These are simple things.
Sir, not get the correct active word, but there is a mobile app, and mobile appearance is there.
Forget about that. That we will discuss later. Down below, you can see web page, tab page, etc. Bothered about, just get interested in those kind of things. You just concentrate on web page. Mobile means slowly at the end of the day, we'll be going to mobile. If you want a different look in your mobile, as and when we link it with mobile, we'll be changing that.
Sir, don't worry about that. The correct word appearance shows only in that section. There is maybe another theme is used where.
No, you change the theme. That is enough. It automatically gets changed. Everything will change accordingly.
That means it included in notification, registration, then model services and advanced features. That is one.
No. You go appearance. Down to appearance. Go down to Vagisa, you go down to appearance.
Okay.
I told not to wait there.
Appearance, okay. Then what
go
to do?
Appearance, click on to themes.
Themes, okay.
Then come to theme selector.
Oh, theme selector, okay.
You can see this page, no? This
yes, one. Yes, I see.
So click on to this one and change it. Save changes. If you don't want, you are happy with this one, it's okay.
Okay
then. Can I go? Should I wait or can I go to the next one?
The next one, okay. Then, after that.
So, next, friends, we are going to the important part, including the stakeholder in the process. Now, the same process, go to site administration. Go to site administration. Relax. After I explain this process, I'll be stop sharing and I'll be asking each one of you to come forward and share your screen so that I'll be in a position to guide you properly. Those latecomers, please wait. I am in the screen and I'll not be in a position to permit you. So regarding site, go to site administration, click on to site administration. Then you can see users. Site administration, you can see notification, registration, Moodle services, advanced features. Below advanced features, you can see users. Click on to users. Click on to users. Then as you click on to users, you can see accounts. Below users, you can see accounts. Click on to accounts. So site administration, go down, not at notification, not at registration, not at Moodle services. Click on to advanced features. Below that, there is users. Click on to users, accounts, click on to accounts. Add a new user. So advanced features, down below users, click on to users, add a new user. Either you can click on to this link or the left link, the link which is shown in the middle, or to the left end, you can see add a new user, click on to that. Then what you can see is this one, username. I asked you to collect 5 to 10 names of your students, their full name, their email address, and their password. I have told you S capital, St. Joseph's, S is added at 1, 2, 3. The first letter is capital, followed by small letters, then a symbol that is at, along with numbers. So your password should be alphanumeric. Username, my suggestion is use the first part of the email, that is before at. All in small letters is better, rather than asking them to type the first name in capital and to follow. So use normally the system accept only small letters. So first part, all in small letters, insert it and complete the process. First name, surname, email address. Do one thing, copy the email address, paste it on email address, copy that email address on username, delete at gmail.com, and it will be your username. Then new password, click on, you know there is a pencil and there is an I near to it. Click on to pencil and click on to I and type the name. You can see the password there. So there should not be any mistake. For editing, you need to click on to pencil. For seeing what you are typing, click on to the I nearby that.
Excuse me, sir, for the username, what is needed? Username, their name.
Yeah, this is their email address.
Their email address, okay.
Yeah.
Sir, could you please explain that once again, sir?
Oh, sure. So, friends, this is the important part. Because as we complete this process, 10 numbers is more than sufficient. We will be taking the screenshot and using it for your future. So keep that in mind. First, you take the Word file or the Excel file you have created. In that, you got the 10 names and their email address. 10 names of the student and their email address. Copy the email address. Can you copy the email address? Friends, listen, stop doing, listen and copy the email address. Take the email address and paste it on email address. You can see the red one in email address. Let the whole thing be pasted there. The whole email address is better. Now, click on to user and paste it there. But remove at gmail.com. So that means the first part of their Gmail account is their username. And at gmail.com is absent. Delete at gmail.com. Then type the first name. If you don't know the surname, put some alphabet or G or something like that. Suresh G, Sumesh G, something like that. Now, after that, go to new password. Click to enter text. You can see a pencil nearby that. Click that pencil. But after clicking the pencil, there is an I nearby that. Click on to that I, because I want only a universal password, that is St. Joseph's at 123. S capital, that means first letter should be capital, STJOSCPHS. At, that is the symbol, 123 is the numbers.
St. Joseph's. Password,
if you want, that will be putting you into trouble. Sometimes you will be typing, sometimes you will not be. So, as far as possible, the fingers should be in the alphabet rather than going to other things. Because then you will be, if you are smart enough, you can do. If you are giving St. Joseph's apostrophe, it's well and good. And then enter. As we have typed in topic now, you, after typing the matter, you can enter. The password will be saved. So enter this password in the file you have prepared as the last one. Insert a new column, give the heading as password and type the password there. Repeat this process for all your students, and I am stopping here, and you all will start sharing the screen to me.
How the email display?
Forget about that.
Okay.
Don't get into technicalities. Technicalities, Varghese sir, don't worry, we'll be consulting after this. You just complete the simple process, we'll be discussing about. If you want,
sir, do we create new user?
Eh?
Sir, we create new user? after that, after entering all this?
Save. Last one, you can go down. You can go down. Create user. Friends, one more thing. See, normally in our university, when we need the email address of student, we'll be logging into the university site, from where you can get the email address, full address, contact number, etc., along with their photo. If you want to insert their photo, come down, you can see new picture, click onto that folder and specify the path, you can insert the photo as well. Hello, have you seen that? Down below. You can, if you want, but to me that is a big process, so I will not encourage that. If you are damn interested, you can go ahead. Click on to that.
Every time we add, we have to create user.
Yes. Yes.
For each one.
But yeah, but if you are adding 100, means you need to develop a CSV file and click onto that and add it. That is a tedious process. Let us confine to just 10 numbers. By individual manual enrollment, we will do that. For there, maybe the organizers will be conducting some advanced courses. At that time, we'll be discussing about those kind of things. For the time being, let us depend on manual enrollment so that there is no mistake creeping up into the enrollment process. Finally, after inserting the photo, create user. Create user. Friends, after entering each person, please highlight or bold the person centered. We just want to know what are the names. Okay, then I am stop sharing. Create user, and friends, please show me the screen. Ronu ma'am, there are certain double enrollments are there. Some person are in two modes.
Maybe they are fearing of getting lost.
Okay.
That is why there.
Hello, friends. I am waiting for you. After creating the user, show me the user list. Accounts. Show me the users in that list. Ruchi ma'am, you are live. Great.
Sir, meanwhile, can you help those who are waiting to enter?
Yeah. That is going on along with this one. As and when I stop sharing, I'll be permitting each one of them. Don't worry about that.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay, ma'am. Neelu ma'am, it is great. Can you show me down? Only two users. Neelu ma'am, as a principal.
Okay, sir.
Neelu ma'am, just joking.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
So we'll be enrolling them into that particular course. Next one, please. Kashyap, please share your screen. Ruchi ma'am, you are live. Great.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You are from Jabalpur.
Yes, sir.
Is there raining there?
Yes, sir. Pardon?
Is it raining there? No.
No.
Okay. Vasu ma'am, you are live. Show me.
Abhi. Beta, ye drawing room ka darwaza bhi khol de.
Also, ma'am, can you show me some more names? Just only one name is there. Akanksha Singh. Can I take a look at the other one?
Sir, excuse me, sir. Good morning, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, the same password for all. Password.
Sorry? Password? Yeah, same password.
Password.
Yeah.
For all.
When you create these kind of things, the best thing you can do is use the same password. Hello, please be quiet. Kamala ma'am, please be quiet.
For all the 10 students, the same password we have to use.
Yeah, that's better, because their username will be different now. It will be email address.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
if you want, you can permit them to change. But tomorrow, do you know what they will be telling? Ma'am, I am not able to access the site. I don't know the password, and you will do the process. You need to do the process again. Do you, are you interested in taking such kind of trouble? Then you are always welcome.
Thank you.
So better you use that particular password, because these are notes, no? Don't worry. They are not going to do something about that. But if for advanced learners, you can give them an independent password so that other naughty ones will not interfere in their academic activities. Okay, ma'am. Great. Shruti, ma'am. Nice. You are fast. You have enrolled 7, 6. Great.
Six, sir.
Great. Can you complete to 10 so that I can take a look at others? Friends, Kashyap sir, Kashyap Mahanta, you are live. Can you show me the screen? Hello? Kashyap sir? He has switched off the screen, huh? Hello, anyone else? Can I go back? Kamala ma'am, you are live. Only 3 names, sir. See, this is what I told you to take a screen print, because there you can see the date of enrollment and last access. Yeah. You said general type 1. Yeah, tell me. What is the doubt?
Here, should we force the password? Should I click,
yes,
tick mark to this force password change?
No. Then you are getting into trouble, because every now and then the student will be calling you and telling you, ma'am, I am not able to access the site. I am not able to submit the assignment. I am not able to appear for the MCQ because I forgot the password. You force the password and the password will be mailed to him. So tell him, no, your password is this thing. You use it and log in. Don't give me such kind of lame excuses. Like that you can shout also. Okay, so better you keep a universal password for a particular sem. That will be best. But for advanced learners, if you want, you can give them an independent one, or if you can also ask them to change their password. But also you will be getting into trouble. Okay then. Because they know they are not hardworking. They are smart working. They will be using all the smart techniques. Okay then. Anyone else? Can I go back? Yes, I am going back. Kashyap. Kashyap, don't worry. I am here. But though you have messaged me that you lost connection, I can see you live.
Yes, sir. Many times I lost connection. That's why I could not show you.
Doesn't matter.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
See, when you are into information technology, you know, you should have a plan A and a plan B, or a plan C as well. Okay. So relax.
Thank you, sir.
Just text me and I will be responding to you. Have you done this enrollment process?
No, sir. I could not register, sir. Till now, I could not register, sir.
Forget about registration. Go to enrollment. Go to site administration.
Then yes, sir.
Users. Go down. You can see some 7 or 8. After 7 or 8, you can see users, accounts.
Yes, sir.
Add new user and complete the process.
Yes, sir. Okay. I will follow your recordings.
Yeah. Okay, great.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
You have completed 5-1, sir. That's enough.
Okay, great. Okay, sir, great. Anyone else? Hello?
But, sir, my name also in the list.
Boss, you are the admin now.
Okay, that is the reason.
Your name will be found everywhere.
Okay.
Don't get irritated by your name.
Okay.
Anyone else? Hello. So I'm going back. Friends, we had created the user. Now we need to go to this is what I have incorporated my photo, my username, etc., etc., and this is the page. Okay, then now I am going back to my course, that is economics. So I'll be clicking on to economics, and now you can see the name displayed here. Friends, do one thing, click on to your particular course, and the name will be displayed here. Name will be displayed there. Have you reached that screen? Hello? Hello?
Sir, then please
click on to participate home.
Sir, please repeat.
See, go back. This is my course, the one highlighted in blue. Select, go to home. Go to home, home screen. I know you are sitting in your home, but this is home screen. Go to home screen. Go to the page, the full page. You can see all the courses. Select the particular course you where you want to enroll this group of students. Tomorrow, what I want is all of you need to create some more courses. Today, yesterday we created content for a particular course. Now, create some more links, some more courses, and I want to see a populated page in front of you. Now click on to the particular course. You can see the page displayed like this. Have you seen that one?
Sir.
Have you seen that one? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Okay, great, great. Thank you, thank you. See, I was waiting for these responses. So otherwise, I thought of explaining a little bit more. For homepage, go to the left top. You can see the short form or your site name. Click onto that. It will take you there. Now, you can see courses. What you will be seeing is the navigation page. You can see courses and participants. Click onto participants. Click on to participants. Then as you click on to participants, it will be asking like this. Participants, no filters applied, enroll users. On the right hand side, that finger pointing, you can see enroll users. Click on to enroll users. Your course. Participants, on to the right side you can see enroll courses. Left side what we did was we went to the course, we came to participants, and we are
enrolled. We have to enroll ourselves also.
No, you are already there.
Okay.
Wait. I will tell you. Then while enrolling, you should see the second part as well. See, while enrolling, you can select. If you want, you can enroll yourself, but doesn't matter if you enroll or not. If you can enroll, you should be in a position to enroll the faculty. Click on to the second one. You can see student. Faculty, etc. Boss, Varghese sir, you are the administrator. You are the,
yes.
What you can say for that computer, there is a systems administrator of that particular college. You are in charge of this system, the computer system. So you are the domain administrator. You are not a faculty. You are assigned to enroll the faculty. So here you are enrolling the student. Search for their one or two letters. They will be showing. Click onto that, enroll. But see to it that down below it is specified as student. Otherwise, they will be editing. So don't, while enrolling, see that first you click onto student, then start enrolling one by one. I need to see all enrolled. And if you are enrolling a faculty for a particular thing, now you can enroll yourself as the manager or a faculty. So what you can do is you can enroll yourself as a manager. Click on to the down student. change it into manager, because you are managing the site, you are the administrator, you keep it as manager. Maybe your particular paper is taken by two persons, you include that person as the faculty as well. So type your name for 2-3 letters, it will be showing the extension. Click onto that, enroll user. And now I am stopping here, and I want to see the two types of enrollment.
Sir, enroll myself, sir. Sir, enroll myself also.
Yes, as manager.
Yes, yeah, yes, sir.
Friends, each one of you start sharing your screen.
Sir, is it is right? Sir? Hello, sir. I can't hear.
Sir, your voice is not audible, sir.
Yes, sir. Rolu ma'am, I think resource person has put his audio in mute.
Sir?
Sorry. Neelu ma'am? Neelu ma'am?
Yes, sir. Yes,
you're
sir.
The boss now. You can enroll as faculty as well. Type okay. Enroll a new person, enroll a name, and you type the name of a faculty and enroll as a faculty as well. Is it possible?
Okay. Okay, so thank you, sir. Thank you.
Because you're asking them to use this one, the module which you had created.
Okay, ma'am. Otherwise, it is okay, sir. Manager.
Perfect.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Boss, you are always perfect. Okay, then. Next one. Ruchi, ma'am, you are live.
Yes, sir.
Ruchi, ma'am?
Yes, sir.
Student, what about your role?
Don't
you have any faculty for the course? I think you need to appoint some guest faculty at least.
Okay,
only
sir.
Students are
okay,
there.
Sir.
They are making lot of noise. Please appoint a guest faculty.
Sir, participant role student pe wahan kya karna hai sir yahan?
Yahan pe aapne student? Nahi, wahan pe nahi. You don't
yes,
want
sir?
To do the process yes. Again. Do the enrollment and after yes. Yahan pe na enroll user. वहां पे जरा क्लिक करो ना यहाँ पे एनरोल यूजर टॉप हाँ टॉप ऊपर या नीचे चलेगा एनरोल यूजर क्लिक ऑन टू एनरोल यूजर
यस सर अगेन आई ट्राई एंड एनरोल
होल्ड ऑन सी हियर यू कैन सी स्टूडेंट
यस सर आई कैन
क्लिक ऑन टू दैट
यस सर आई कैन डू एज अ मैनेजर आई
नो डू वन थिंग क्लिक ऑन टू दैट स्टूडेंट लेट मी आल्सो सी whether it
yes,
is working
sir.
Or not. See, I am not checking you, but I am checking the site. I have certain doubts about this site. That is why.
No, sir. So, I add, then after I share my screen.
Click on to that student and you can see faculty, manager, etc. You
yes,
enroll
sir.
As the manager, you enroll one of your friend as your faculty and you can work on that.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, sir, you are live. That is perfect.
No please problem.
Doesn't matter.
Okay.
The manager can be here or behind the screen.
Okay, thank you.
So it is up to you. Stop sharing. Next one, please. See, friend, I want to see the whole thing. Please appoint, if you don't have faculty, at least appoint some guest faculty, please. Yes, ma'am. Punita, ma'am, you are like manager. See, manager is the CEO. Can you do me a favor?
Yes, sir.
Incorporate a faculty as well.
Okay, sir.
Is the manager just administrator or is he looking into the things? Means it's okay. And what I want is, I want you to change the things, no roles. I want to see a teacher also in that one. That will be good.
Okay.
Yes, for. Expertise in this module.
Okay.
Okay then. Enroll. Do the process. Enroll. Mm. Enroll. Add a new user and enroll him as a faculty.
Oh.
Okay, ma'am. Nice. Okay. Next one, please. Faster. Hello. Neelu, ma'am. Great. You are back. Neelu, ma'am. Yes. Yeah, teacher. Great. So, Katwe, ma'am. Cut to Aparna, ma'am, as well.
Yeah. Thank you, sir.
Okay then. Smita, ma'am, you are live. All teachers are there. Where are the students? No admission process has started. No. That's not fair. Please start your admission. Forget about the COVID lockdown. Hello. Vasu, ma'am, there is a big trouble. We had enrolled only teachers. Edit and change it into student. Click onto that pencil and change it into student. Vasu, ma'am. Click onto that pencil. Yeah, click onto that. There is a pencil or a pencil.
I have enrolled one teacher, sir.
No, you have enrolled so many teachers.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, can you do one thing? Tanya, ma'am, do it again. That is better. Manager, teacher together. Teacher is better. Okay. Sometimes it will not work. Don't shout at me. Okay. Yeah, teacher. Yeah, great.
Thank you, sir.
Okay then. Stop sharing. Vasu, ma'am, change from faculty to teacher. Student, manager, teacher. Great. Kamala, ma'am, you are great.
Yes, sir.
Okay. This is where we need the focus of students.
Go, we will talk about it. Go.
Nita, ma'am, you are live. Yes, Nita, ma'am, perfect. Great. Job sharing. Can I take a look at others, please? Faster. Come fast.
Yes,
sir. So, friends who are sitting idle, Take a new tab, type multiple choice questions and search for your domain, MCQs of your domain. Division, sir, there is an issue.